What an honor it is today to celebrate the Chattanooga State Community College Class of 2020. You will go down in history as the Chattanooga State class that arguably overcame more challenges and persevered more than any other class in our 54-year history. You have so very much to celebrate. You overcame challenges that many community college students face. Many graduates enrolled at Chattanooga State while also juggling outside responsibilities. You've worked full-time. You've taken care of children. You've cared for your parents. Over 40% of today's graduates came back to college as adults. Many of you enrolled at Chattanooga State as the first member in your family to pursue a college education, perhaps doubting that you could be successful in college. Like me, almost 30% of you are the first in your family to graduate from college. You've learned how to push yourself harder than you ever thought possible. You successfully completed that anatomy and physiology class, that math class, and all those essays for English. Many of you came to school hungry, not knowing when you might be able to afford your next meal. Many of you came to school worried, not knowing if you would be able to pay this month's rent. Yet, you persevered. Graduates, you have persevered through challenges that no students in the history of American higher education have had to face. The emergence of COVID-19 threatened your health and the health of your family and friends. Many students and their family members lost their jobs. The global pandemic required most schools around the world to switch to online learning, and Chattanooga State was no exception. This move to online learning brought additional challenges. Some of you lacked access to reliable internet connectivity. Some of today's graduates did not have a laptop or a computer at home. Perhaps you doubted your ability to learn and succeed online. Yet, you persevered. Then on Sunday, April 12th, a day when many of our in our community were celebrating Easter, a natural disaster struck our community. Tornadoes blew in, leaving many of you without electricity and internet connection. Worse, some of you lost the safe haven of your homes. You faced financial uncertainty, school delays, work delays, and more canceled plans. Yet, you persevered. You, the class of 2020, have persevered through more than any previous class. Common challenges, rare challenges, unprecedented challenges. You used your intelligence, resilience, and grit to finish your classes, to finish your degrees, and to never give up on your dreams or yourself. I cannot promise you that the road ahead will be without challenges. In fact, the one thing that I can promise you is that life will present challenges, plans will change, and the unexpected will happen. But you now possess a college education. You will move forward armed with your internal strengths that brought you here today, with your intelligence, resilience, and grit, you can overcome everything that life throws at you. And with your degree, you can achieve anything you want. Congratulations, class of 2020. The future is yours. Your time is now. The world waits for you to change it. Go make your mark.
Congratulations to the class of 2020. You are graduating in the most unprecedented times in our nation. The pandemic of 2020, COVID-19, has caused many changes in the lives of every one of you, but you have managed to persevere. You've had three great qualities that have allowed you to continue on with your education. You've had great fortitude, you've had a great attitude, and you've been grateful to those that have helped you through this process. For many of you, you did not wish this degree to happen, but you worked for this degree to happen. I'm so proud of all that you've accomplished, that you've made it to this point in your life, and now know that you have the skills to be successful in whatever career path you've chosen to go down. We were here to support you during your times of studies, and we will be here to support you during your times of graduation. Please remember that you're very important to us. You'll be our best alumni ever, and we know that you have the strength to survive no matter what comes your way. Congratulations again to all of the graduates today, to all of the families that are here that have supported you, and to every path that you choose to go down from now on. Congratulations, the class of 2020.
I have the honor to introduce to you today our commencement speaker. Katrina Griffin returned to Chattanooga State as a Tennessee Reconnect student in the fall of 2017. As an Associate of Science General Transfer major, Katrina worked hard not only in her academic career, but also in her personal life. Overcoming illnesses, raising two children, and working full-time did not stop Katrina from pursuing her dreams. Her hard work was recognized in the fall of 2019 when she was named Chattanooga State's SOAR Award winner, the East Tennessee SOAR Award winner, and most recently, Chattanooga State's President's Award winner. Katrina was chosen as a top three finalist for the State of Tennessee SOAR Award out of 100,000 community college students from across the state. Katrina is a member of Phi Theta Kappa, Inspire Honor Society for Adult Learners. Katrina's love for learning inspires her to be an advocate for Tennessee Reconnect, speaking at many Tennessee Reconnect information sessions for Chattanooga State. All of the awards and recognitions Katrina has received, she's most proud of the love and support she receives from her husband, Jeremy, who she's been married to for 15 years, and their two children, Justin and Lauren. Katrina is currently a student at Middle Tennessee State University and will be graduating with her bachelor's degree in December of 2020, just 3 years after returning to college. And today she makes history as our first ever virtual commencement speaker.
Hello, faculty, staff, fellow classmates, family, and friends, and welcome to the first and hopefully last Chattanooga State virtual graduation for the class of 2020. I started ChattState in the fall of 2017, and I was so nervous. It was my third attempt at college. I was 31, and I had an 11 and 9-year-old at home. I worked full-time, but thankfully, I had the help of my wonderful husband and family. I always wanted a college degree, and I was always self-conscious of the fact that I did not have one. I held only entry-level jobs, and it was discouraging because I knew I was capable of more. When I tried to return to college the first two times, it never worked. The first time I was 20 years old and had a six-month-old baby. I remember when I went to campus, I felt so old, which is hilarious now. The second time I started the registration process and didn't even finish. I knew I wouldn't succeed. My life during my 20s was completely unsettled. I experienced illnesses ranging from heart surgeries to strokes, and my children also experienced sicknesses. My son had heart surgery, and my daughter had a severe kidney issue that kept her in the hospital the first year of her life. Once we were all getting healthy, I entered a depressive stage that kept me at an all-time low. Thankfully, my husband had a very successful career, and he was moving up in the company he worked for. He was very fulfilled, and I desperately wanted what he had. My job of being a front desk receptionist felt anything but meaningful, but I knew there was nothing more for me unless I could finish school. I had already failed so many times at college, I was embarrassed to even try again. Everything changed one day when I was driving to work and I heard a Tennessee Reconnect ad on the radio, and it seemed as if maybe I would qualify for the program, meaning a completely free education. For the first time in a long time, I felt hope and excitement about something. I told my husband I wanted to try one more time. I enrolled at ChattState, half thinking I could do it, half knowing I would fail, but regardless, I knew this was my last attempt. If I didn't do it then, I never would. My advisor, Ron Peck, was my advisor each time I attempted to go to college. I felt embarrassed emailing him, asking him for an appointment because I wanted to come back to school again. However, when I met with him, he was so encouraging. He had complete confidence that I would finish, and his confidence rubbed off on me. His positivity and reassurance was exactly what I needed at that time. Once the semester started, I was so determined to finish. I knew nothing would keep me from quitting this time. Little did I know that the third week into the semester, the day of my very first anatomy and physiology test, I would be hit by a school bus. It happened at 9 in the morning, and my class started around 5 that evening. While the accident was not quite as dramatic as it sounds, I was pretty shaken up. However, I refused to not go to class that night. While I wish this part of my life story had an amazing ending, like I passed the test with flying colors, it doesn't. I failed my very first college test. I was disappointed, but I refused to give up. I did, however, change my major from nursing to something that suited me a little more. As the first semester came to an end, I felt so proud of myself. I did it. I had finished a semester of college. Before I knew it, I finished a few more and I was about to graduate. Receiving an email from Miss Bonnie Riggs asking me to schedule my exit exam was so exciting, but I never dreamed of all the amazing things that would come from it. From that email exchange, I was able to meet so many amazing staff members at ChattState. I was nominated and won several awards that I am so proud of and honored to have. Today, I'm a student at MTSU, and I'm on track to graduate this coming December 2020 with my bachelor's degree. While I am so thankful for my bachelor's degree and the opportunities it will provide, my degree at ChattState will always mean so much to me. My time at ChattState taught me to embrace my failures because my failures made me who I am today. I learned to finally believe in myself, I overcame adversity, and most of all, I learned to never stop trying. Finally, I want to take a moment and thank my family and all of the people who made this virtual graduation possible. While I am here speaking to you alone, and I'll be walking across the stage alone, I definitely did not accomplish this alone. My husband, Jeremy, is truly my best friend and my biggest supporter. This day would not be possible without him. My children, Justin and Lauren, were always there to quiz me, write me notes of encouragement on test days, and understood when I had to miss an event so I could attend class, study, or finish a paper. My in-laws always jumped in to babysit when needed. My parents supported me from afar in Alaska, and watching my sister-in-law be a military wife, raising two kids practically alone while her husband serves our beautiful country, continually gave me inspiration that if she can do that, then I can finish college. The logistics of allowing each graduate to walk across the stage in the middle of a pandemic is a difficult feat, but ChattState has made that possible for us. So, a big thank you to every person who worked tirelessly to make this event happen. Graduates, Even though we have accomplished a major milestone of receiving a degree, I want to encourage each one of you to continue to pursue your dreams, regardless of what it takes to get it done. If this year has taught us anything, it's that life can change in an instant. Continue to grow and be your best self. Congratulations, class of 2020. We did it.
Now presenting the graduates from the Business Division.
Thank you.
Now presenting the graduates from the Engineering and Information Technologies Division.
Thank you.
now presenting the graduate from the Humanities and Fine Arts Division. Now presenting the graduates from the Mathematics and Sciences Division. Now presenting the graduates from the Nursing and Allied Health Division. Mm-hmm. Now presenting the graduates from the Social and Behavioral Sciences Division.
Thank you.
Now presenting the graduates from Collegiate High. Now presenting the Associate Degrees in University Parallel.
Thank you. Thank you. dark. At the end of a storm, there's a golden sky and the sweet silver song of a lark. Walk on through the wind, walk on through the rain, though your dreams be tossed and blown. Walk on, walk on with hope in your heart, and you'll never walk alone. Walk on through the wind, walk on through the rain, though your dreams be tossed and blown.